Welcome. Today we're doing a bit more of the standard ladder. I've got a almost a runes deck that I thought I should try out. It's got some of the bits and pieces. So I've got four Showdown of the Scalds, which I've been sort of lucky enough to just get randomly. The bit I'm mainly missing, I've only got one Runeforge champion, so I'm sort of improvising. I've got a few just good cards, basically. Skyclave Apparition, Wedding Announcement, Helanna and Alayna, and Jugen Defends the Temple. And the other thing I've done, I actually spent some wild cards yesterday. So I decided I'm not going to do any more. I'm very unlikely to do any more Zendikar Rising drafts, so I've gone and spent, I think, nine wild cards completing my Naya pathways, basically. So that will give me a few untapped lands to play with, basically. I've still got some tapped things. I've got a Lorehold Campus and a couple of Cabaretti Courtyards. But yeah, only three tap lands left in the deck, so it should be pretty decent. So I'm not playing any removal cards in the deck. And my reasoning is I've got life gain creatures. So I can kind of, that's how I can fight against aggro. Oh well. Oh, my one Skyclave Apparition is my only removal spell. So this opening hand's quite slow, but we'll see if we can see how we do. That's a lucky top deck. You definitely don't want to do a turn three Showdown of the Scalds, I would say. I think it wastes a lot of potential of the card. Actually, that's that campus, that's our second white source for the apparition. So this can definitely be a red source. And we'll go with Fable of the Mirror Breaker. Right, what are we discarding here? Maybe Skyclave Apparition. Or maybe not. No, we've got a really good nice combo with Skyclave Apparition. So, keep everything. Let's submit zero. Just attack with this guy. We'll play this guy. So yeah, this is the deck with Lord Xander the Collector. The apparition won't work on that because it can only do mana value 4 things. He could have a sweeper. Just thinking if I should play around that. Let's go with a. Let's try a Skyclave Apparition on the Mirror Breaker. Could go naturalist and showdown. Could also copy something, which is interesting. Try copying a generous visitor, I think. Playing a Nuke-Duke Naturalist. So this has got haste. Do showdown of the skulls. Interesting. Okay, we'll just swing with this guy. Oh, I know what he does. He brings back Xander the Collector. Yeah. That makes sense. And I'll lose a bunch of cards. Do I want to discard? Yeah, we can discard Communion of Spirits. That's okay. Library milled, okay. Sure, no blocks. And okay, yeah, they're all down. That's his sweeper. Right. So, generous visitor. Never mind. Let's try drawing a card, see if we can draw something. Let's try and find something. Well, we're not going to kill him. We'll do no attacks. Oh, that's nice. Yeah, makes sense. Yeah, unfortunately, we've only got one Kami of Transience as well. But, might add more. Toxril. When he dies, I lose half my permanence, sure. Try doing that. So, that's good. Imran's down. Three cards left. Probably decline. Interesting how we just couldn't get more than one green source, but it's all been milled off the top, I suppose. That's a better card when you've already got a creature in play. just realised. Thought, I'll fancy playing it before I die. Still not big enough to attack with, never mind. Right, probably not going to use the card draw things. Wait, what am I doing? What am I doing? Decline. Decline. Don't want to just, draw myself to death. Pop out a generous visitor. Let's concede. Yeah, I had that sinking feeling that I was playing into a board wipe. Sure enough, he had Battle of Frost and Fire. Which you don't see every day. Right, commune with spirits we've got. We could get a plains first, I suppose. Probably. I wonder if it's the mill deck. Think we're playing this guy. Oh, okay. Right, we could go Spirited Companion and Commune with Spirits. Or we could just play Fable of the Mirror Breaker, Duke and Defense the Temple. I think I like this one. It's another way of ramping out more stuff. Oh, right. Cleansing Wildfire, sure. It's a deck that copies his stuff. I'm guessing another Cleansing Wildfire would be about right. Got a lot of things. Fable of the Mirror Breaker. Spirits. Maybe we can discard both fables. Seems crazy, but we want land at this point. We've got land. Perfect. Let's see. We'll commune with spirits first. Figure out what we're looking for. Maybe got enough land. Yeah, our rune's pretty good. And maybe just thinking. Go for the green side of this and play Jugan. Yep. Okay, that's three removal spells so far. He's going this would suggest he's going land destruction. Field of Ruin. Has to be a non-basic land. Okay. Cleansing Wildfire can destroy any land, of course. So I can take out my red source. Ooh, it'd be good if I could order those so they can happen the right way around. Right, so we're going to need a another red source, I suppose. So we'll do that. Go Spirited Companion, Weaver of Harmony, I suppose. might be running. I think it's okay at this point. Forge champion, interesting. Okay, we'll play a Weaver of Harmony. We might be running into a board wipe, but we are okay with it. I think against land destruction, just get your stuff out whilst you can. Can't kill all your lands and all your creatures at once, surely. It's got to come up short somewhere. Filling. Feeling this is where I... Oh, Hallowed Haunting. But we don't have double white. I think this is where we go Showdown of the Scourds. Try and hit another land. I got a Forest of Lucky, which is lucky. It managed to tap all my green, casting that. Because then we can go Weaver of Harmony. She drew two Showdown of the Scourds, which is very silly. Oh yeah, Arcane Bombardment, I remember. That's a card. Now he's got to cast something to trigger it. Okay, there we go. Igneous Inspiration, sure. He gets to cast something else for free, which is Spikefield Hazard. That's a shame. Is he going to run out of fuel, though? Because he needs to cast something every time to trigger it. Oh, he's not, because he's got a learn card, so he can get... He can use that to trigger it. Ah, very nice. Okay. Only got one white mana. Right. So, Rune of Sustenance. Let's go. No. Showdown of the Scourge. I've got to resolve that. Why have I got to resolve that? Okay. Oh yeah, gotta resolve that. Okay, sure. We're going to play this one. Wait, or are we? Yeah, we'll play this one to get a white source, so we can play that Rune of Sustenance. Okay. We could use that to no. Spikefield hazard happens, but what else? Expressive iteration. Okay. This triggers off the first thing, not every single thing. Excuse me for a second. Okay. Let's see what we can do here. This will actually get more lands out of the deck, but this will let me cast more things, I suppose. Yeah, we start with begin with the Kami, because that's going to get tokens. Cathartic Pyre. Sure, Cleansing Went, Wildfire. We will. Okay, Expressive Iteration, sure. See, because it triggers in my turn as well, of course. Right. Let's check. We do have a Rune of Speed, so that's going to come in handy. Left. Okay. Yeah, we don't really want to have any lands left to get out of the deck, unfortunately. Jugan defends the temple. Do we want to do that? Do we have something else we can do? Oh yes, we do. Yeah, we'll do the Rune of Speed on that. Makes a lot of sense to me. Okay. And can we do Jugan Naturalist and then Jugan? I think we can. Got him. We got him. Well, that's our first win with the deck. Pretty exciting. We're not too badly set up for cleansing wildfire decks. We've got 8 basic lands. I sort of start to think Rune of Speed is the best one. There's so many post-board wipe situations where you want something with haste. So I'm sort of tempted to take out... Well... Ah, yeah. At least play with 4 Runes of Speed. Maybe we drop a Wedding Announcement. And 1 Jugan. becoming a bit more like a runes deck. Right, that looks like a good start. Ah, the Park Heights Pegasus. So I think we're in a, this is definitely a racing kind of situation. I want to build up the Naturalist next. Definitely play the tap land. Yeah, I'll keep the generous visitor back. Alright, yeah, I see. Yeah. So, I guess it's more enchantments. There's, yeah, Fable of the Mirror Breaker. We could even do Showdown of the Scalds as well. Get to draw a card, which is pretty nice. pretty confident I can put it all on one guy against red and green. I suppose I could have done Generous Visitor first if I was smart. Two lander, but we do have commune with spirits. Keep it. Search for land next turn. What about you, sir? Okay, we've got nothing. Another rune of speed. No, I think we'll get the double white going, and I think we're happy to trade off. This guy's gonna suddenly become a 4/4 or something. So here it comes, 2/2, 3/3. So probably a 5/5 then. I underestimated. So I'll just take 10 then. And he's got vigilance as well. Nice. Okay. Nice. Gets to wild. Hit for 12 actually. Right. I didn't know about this card. So I need to get my toughness to 5, but that's probably not happening. We need a bit of a chump blocker at this stage. I think we... let's try a commune with spirits. See what we can get. Okay, that's another chump blocker for next turn. That's the way I'm looking at that. Yeah. No attacks. See if we can put trample on it next turn. It's that vigilance that is the real killer. Ah, he's got the trample, okay. Yeah. Game over. So that's 14 damage getting through. So I do just survive. Yes, I think we'll discard one of those and one of those. Yep, we'll draw another one. Alright. Okay. Land is good. Get that land, though, because we can cast this anyway. See if he got the other charge through. Excuse me. That's interesting. I don't think he got charged through. Discard up to two cards. We can discard Forest and Rune of Might. Oh, nice. Okay. I think we'll. Okay. Yeah, we probably should have. That's the other way around, but never mind. See, that does give. That is another way of getting trample as well. Pretty nice. Yeah. So, he tramples through. Bit like the runes deck, really, that one. Okay, this could work. He's gonna go ahead and hit me. Just thinking. Yeah, I'll play the Naturalist. We start with a visitor. And a spirited companion. I mean, it's a black deck, so he's probably got lots of ways of killing this naturalist. Play a forest. Put Rune of Might on the naturalist. Right, sacrifice a creature, so I think we'll lose Generous Visitor. We'll lose a Rune of Might. So, impressive. Oh, you had a treasure to help cast that, of course, that makes sense. Yeah, a bit of communing with spirits I think would be good. What do I want to do? Yeah, I think I can just take the Tatland at this point. I don't think that's a big deal. Yes, it is. Yeah, I made a mistake. Never mind, we'll play, yeah, gotta play the red land to get our Rune of Speed working. So I think we're doing this on here. Cool. I'm just a hit with these two. Okay, yeah. Okay, no red land at the moment. Might be a bit of a slow start. Okay, Weaver of Harmony. Blue, white. And black. Okay, let's keep the pressure up. Do I want to do a commune with spirits first? That's my thinking. Find this red source of mana. Oh, nice. Spell pierce. Got me good. Do I want to go for double white? Yes. Okay, we're prepared for that spell pierce now. Okay, he had obscure charm. Fair enough. Successfully stopped me getting a land there. This double white is messing me up. I need double green this turn. Okay, Cameo Transience. I think is the play. That back. That's Rafine. Yep. Yeah, I think that's looks like that was my fourth win. Just to go over the deck again, so in the course of playing I've gone up to 4 runes of speed. I think that makes sense. After the board wipe, you want the best chance of getting one of these and hasting out one of your creatures. That just seems to make sense. And I'm just, the rest of the deck is sort of constrained by my collection. I don't want to spend, basically I don't really want to spend wild cards on a runes deck. But this is the best selection I can come up with at the moment. So you've got one Cameo of Transience, One Weaver of Harmony. I don't think that this one doesn't get played, I think, in a runes deck, but usually it's in the white green enchantments deck. And yeah, only one Runeforge champion. And just a smattering of other sort of good stuff cards. Yeah, we still got three tap lands in the deck, but in due course, I'll wild card the rest of the lands and it'll be a bit more consistent. But yeah, I think I could get away with about three tap lands without too many problems. That's another video. Right, thanks for watching.